crew on both sides enjoy what should be the best atmosphere you will see this season.
Andy's a little fired up, and now he's going to get angry tweets from Kansas fans and North Carolina fans and Duke fans.
Wherever you're at, that's where you love it the most. That's how I roll. I don't know.
Well, we are ready to get this one started. What a night at Mackey Arena with the Big Ten lead on the line.
Seth, you've been around the country. Look, what can you say about this environment? The intro alone got me off my seat.
It's as good as it gets, and it's an early arriving crowd. They've been ready all day.
P.J. Thompson to work for Purdue. Matthias looking inside. The test in the post right away for Wesson. Carson Edwards underneath to Isaac.
That's going to be a big handful inside for the freshman, Caleb Wesson. Can he defend Haas? And most importantly, can he do it without getting into foul trouble? That's going to be the key for tonight.
13 to shoot for Ohio State. First possession for the Buckeyes. Jackson around the Wesson screen. And a whistle. Backing it out with 3 seconds. No whistle, just a huge crowd. And that's a shot clock violation. There's the whistle.
And I tell you, that's what I wanted to see for Purdue. Could you come out and establish yourselves defensively? They have had all sorts of trouble defending recently. Even Rutgers having their way.
Well, this is only Ohio State's fourth conference road game of the season. Previous road games, Iowa, Rutgers, and Northwestern. No offense to those environments and those teams, but this is a different setup for Ohio State tonight. They're going to have to show their poise.
$1 million move. I'd give it a 10-cent shot because it almost fell. But goodness gracious, that was a fantastic coach move by Vincent Edwards.
C.J. Jackson will kick it out to Andre Wesson. Here's Kata Bates-Diop. And the air ball from three turns it over to Purdue.
Bates-Diop had two switches. One was Isaac Haas, who's too big to guard him, and the other was Carson Edwards, who's too big to guard him, but he settled for a fadeaway three. He's got to drive that.
I think patience is going to come into play here, and it's hard. I mean, you talk about this environment, it gets you going almost to a point where it speeds you up too much.
There's Matthias around the Haas screen.
And he switched everything one through four. Had the mismatch, but Tate made the steal.
First turnover for Purdue. Tate on the attack.
Boom.
No look, finds Wesson, and Wesson through the contact, couldn't get it to go.
Love the no call. Haas went straight up.
Vincent Edwards driving with a left hand, no. Bates Diop with the rebound.
That's where you want to just see a little bit more patience early in the game, especially from Purdue. You've got to trust that you're the superior team and go out and execute.
Bates Diop. Left that one short. Rebound pulled down by Edwards. Kata Bates Diop 0 for 2 tonight. In his career, 0 for 5. He's never scored against Purdue. This is his fourth game. Carson Edwards has just scored for Purdue, and it's 4-0.
That's not exactly how you're going to draw it up, but I think that's what you've got to do against a defense that's going to switch everything. You've got to drive it.
Jackson with a three won't go. Wesson the rebound, kicks it out to Andre Wesson. Second chance for Ohio State. Bates Diop against Vincent Edwards. Won't go. Haas the board. Bates Diop 0 for 3 to start. Edwards got the screen from Haas, and the air ball 3 will go out to Ohio State.
What do you think? Emotions? The shooting's just been a little off. I mean, look, there's a lot going into this game. I mean, we, from a network standpoint, recognize it. You know these 18 to 22-year-olds are thinking the same thing.
Got to get that lather going. They're nervous. John Crispin's in the house. Everyone's nervous tonight.
I swear, I'm more excited about this game than half the guys on the floor. I get so pumped for this.
Has anyone found Andy?
Yeah.
Ohio State 0 for 6 as a team to start, but only down 4. Wesson got a wide open 3. Strong off the heel, and Matthias the ball.
There's a reason he was open. They're going to help off that spot all night long, whoever's playing there.
a 25% shooter from three. Here comes Vincent Edwards off the hesitation. A little pirouette. Won't go. And the rebound to Wesson. A lot of contact between Wesson and Haas. No call. And then Mathias with the rip. Dakota Mathias in transition. And Ohio State scrambling back defensively.
This is where Purdue's got to get into a set. You've got to find a little bit of rhythm by moving the basketball. Get everybody a touch just to get into the rhythm and flow of the game.
And Andre Wesson for Ohio State's been pressed into starting duty because Cam Williams is under suspension. Williams is their best three-point shooter, and Wesson is not much of a three-point threat.
First foul on Caleb Wesson sends us to our first timeout.
This is exactly how you drew it up. Just dribble around in a circle, spin one off the glass, get it to go.
Nothing start to this one. Ohio State 0 for 6 from the floor, and it is a big-time game. How about this? It's the best combined conference record. These two teams are 23-1 through the 24 games in a power conference matchup in the last 20 seasons. Nobody's been this good playing each other this late in the year in conference play in two decades.
Well, once I was able to make out what the heck that thing was all about, it was pretty significant. But it's one you have to read twice. You realize, yeah, I guess at this point.
Can you guys put the graphic back up for John?
Can you just make it in color, too? I do better with pictures.
Made by numbers. See, Micah Potter now in, by the way, for Ohio State.
You're going to have to really take it easy on Caleb Wesson. You can't expect him to play, you know, every time Isaac Haas is in the game, Caleb Wesson's got to be in there. You've got to make sure that Caleb Wesson's playing on his time, not Haas's.
And he does already have one foul, but I'm actually more concerned about his brother, Andre. I mentioned earlier getting the start in place of Cam Williams, who's really Ohio State's best outside threat. And Andre Wesson is not a great outside shooter, and it just is going to pack in the lane and pack in their space. It means you can help on everything. You can clog the lane on Bates Diop. It just makes it that much more difficult. But now you see Jayshon Tate running the point, and C.J. Jackson with the ball now is their natural point guard. He's playing off the ball, and that's all because Cam Williams isn't here.
That's Jackson. The lob for Potter through traffic, and Carson Edwards in there to break it up. Here comes Mathias on the run.
Ohio State's going to have a real hard time scoring against these Broncos tonight.
It's amazing. When they want to defend, they could be really good. I just think they've been so efficient on the offensive end that they just trust to outscore their opponent. They did it against Michigan. Michigan gave them everything they had.
Now arms of the game for Purdue. Hands off to Mathias. Calling for it underneath. There's P.J. Thompson instead.
He's going to shoot that.
Three on the shot clock. Vincent Edwards in traffic. The pull-up with one to shoot. No, and Bates Diop the rebound.
Thought they missed Harms inside. He had Jayshon Tate at 6'4" on him. That's going to be there all night.
Potter the handoff to Jackson.
Does Jayshon Tate know he's 6'4"?
No.
I think he thinks he's about 6'10".
Potter will try deep. He won't hit. Nobody hitting for Ohio State. Mathias for three. Potter with the rebound. 5.5 minutes without a point, without a bucket for Ohio State on the road. Tate on the run. Tough degree of difficulty, and the first points are on the board for the Buckeyes.
That's as tough a two as you'll see. I think Ohio State, John, would like to get some transition buckets, but Purdue's so good at getting back.
Yeah, they really are. They have no reason to send too many to the offensive glass, and I think that's what they have. Here you go. Why not? You better capitalize.
Jackson does. And it's a one-point game, you know, despite the terrible start.
It's a great point, though, Seth, because when a defense gets set, they get confident. They communicate even better. You got to force a retreating defense to try to figure out how to communicate and transition. But then you got to take transition, turn that right into your secondary break.
Arms the handoff to Edwards. Edwards, Jackson got the steal again. C.J. Jackson with numbers. Jackson, the dump off to Bates Diop, and his first 2 points in his career against the Purdue Boilermakers give Ohio State the lead.
I think someone's fact-checking that one. That's a hard one to believe. At the Big Ten, you know, front-runner for player of the year is the first time in what?
Four games now. He's played four. Didn't play, of course, last year with the injury against Purdue. Mathias got free for a moment. Finds Thompson for three.
Ohio State doing a great job switching off those dribble handoffs. They're so connected defensively. Great team defense.
Jackson the bounce to Potter. Ooh, yeah. Got three of Edwards and a foul.
A little bunny hop there before that shot.
I'm always good when I get a second look at it. You show it to me again, I'll definitely call it. I guess they're just going to call it.
I mean, if
he hasn't gained control yet.
I didn't realize you could. Is that like the NFL? Is it a catch? I didn't realize you could catch the ball, nice jump in the air, come down on 2 feet, dribble, and then take a layup. That's a new one for me.
I'm still not sure what a catch is.
Andy Katz, how's Ohio State handling this atmosphere here at Mackey?
Well, I talked to Chris Holtman before the game, and I said, how could you mimic this? He says, of course you can't. And he harkened back to November. I think Seth might have been at this game. He says, the only thing that was close to what we may experience tonight was when we played Gonzaga in Portland at the PK80. He said that was a road environment. Outside of that, he says, this is going to be nothing like they're going to see this season. But he did remark about the experience these guys have, and that's why he was not worried about going into this kind of environment.
Well, they fall behind 5-0, roll off 8 straight to take the 8-5 lead.
And all done with Caleb Wesson on the bench, too. So the defense is picked up and it sets in. Defense turning into offense just makes it easier.
On the drive, there's a foul. Carson Edwards headed to the free throw line.
And that was a totally different offensive set. They went away from the dribble handoffs. Try to space the floor a little bit more.
That's 2 on Micah Potter, so that may force the hand of Chris Holtman with Caleb Wesson.
And what you're going to see, teams then that are going against a defense that's going to switch, you're going to make the big be a screener. You're going to down screen, force them to hedge hard, and let guys like Isaac Haas make reads. But Carson Edwards does a great job of curling hard right off the screen.
Edwards in the lead. Here comes Caleb Wesson back into the game. Musa Jallo checking in for the first time. They wanted to get to the 10-minute mark, did Chris Holtman and his coaching staff, with one foul for Caleb Wesson. Still got 2:52 to go.
Oh, man, it's the little things, man. It's the little things that count. He just took Isaac Haas down. It was obviously not a foul.
You guys feel those tremors?
Man,
those
I'll tell you.
I felt like I was back in L.A.
That's just a big body.
Ground shook.
That's 560 pounds of basketball weight hitting the ground.
Goodness gracious.
That's a lot of carbohydrates hitting the floor there. But, you know, talk about the challenge of going against Purdue and staying out of foul trouble. Isaac Haas is 11th in the country in fouls drawn for 40 minutes. There are very few players who can score in the post like him and really get your bigs in the foul trouble.
And there's so many fouls that you pick up trying to get around them to fight for position.
Chalo rotated around 15 to shoot as Dockage tries to find some room and he turns it over. Carson Edwards with the steal. Edwards in traffic. He lost it. Dockage bats it out of bounds. It'll stay with Purdue. And this crowd wanted a foul.
It looked like a foul sitting right here. I don't know if they just saw Carson Edwards with his head down and Dockage was in position. I like the no call, quite honestly.
Yeah, I do too.
I love no calls in general.
He was in good legal guarding position, yep. So if anything, it would have been a little bit of a chicken wing foul on Edwards, but I like the no call. A rare offensive miscue from Dockage, by the way. And Haas catching it deep is exactly what Purdue wants. He catches it deep, it's cash.
Look, it's not about the shot that he made. He does that very well, especially left shoulder, right hook. It's the fact that he got position. Once he gets position, you're beat.
C.J. Jackson after Haas picks up his 5th point. And gives Purdue the 9-8 lead. Jackson trying to find some room. Dockage on the baseline. Backs it out. Jallo will try the 3, and he hits. Musa Jallo, 23% on the year from deep. Hey, rains down a 3.
Throw percentages out in this game. Look, you just got to go out and give good minutes, and if you're open, you got to shoot.
Brady Eifert on the floor. Ryan Klein out there as well. Buckeyes 4 for their last 4, but Haas doing some work deep again before the ball got to the post, and an easy 2 for Isaac Haas, who has 7.
They ran the exact same action. They get Haas on the pin-down screen. He's got the guy on his back. All he has to do is turn around, and they throw it to him from the top of the key, not the wing. No,
he was listening to John Crispin who said, throw the percentages out the window, just shoot.
John, you need to be more specific with your comments, please.
Look, I'd probably make a terrible coach, but I like the fact that he's trying to pull Isaac Haas away from the basket. Look, if you're struggling on the offensive end, Seth, that's exactly what you said. You've got to turn defense into easy offensive opportunities. And this was the first basket ever against Purdue for Caleb Dia.
Students look like they're warm outside, but man, they were freezing lined up to get into this one. But why wouldn't you want to get in here? Purdue, 19-game winning streak, the longest in the nation, the best start in the nation, 12-0 start in conference play, 21 straight wins at home, the second longest streak in the nation. You've got a top 15 team in Ohio State in town, trying to knock him from the perch. 11-11 our score early on. 10 to shoot for Purdue. Nojel Eastern, the wild shot not going to go, and the rebound pulled down by Musa Jallo. Purdue still not one offensive rebound in this game.
And for all of Purdue's size, they are not a good offensive rebounding team. Actually 11th in the conference in offensive rebound percentage. So that's one area where I think Ohio State can have an advantage.
Jackson will back it out against Eastern. Around the Wesson screen. Jackson just a step beyond the foul line, barely draws iron. And the rebound to Edwards.
It seems like so many teams just rely on a ball screen to make a play. I think early in the game, it's the most important time to get the ball movement, get bodies cutting, set some screens, figure out how they're going to handle stiffy screen situations, not just ball screens. That's it.
Oh, he missed it. Isaac Haas missed the dunk.
I don't know how this happened. I can't believe it. He's holding that thing like it's a tennis ball. And he's done it a million times. That's hard to do, honestly.
Right. I'll tell you what, he missed the dunk, but he was certainly open. And he's had a couple of opportunities down there off that same action. Dumping down from the top of the key.
Caleb Wesson's got to learn soon that it's all about playing defense early. Playing defense early means just take the catcher. Your job that much easier, or force him into a situation where he's getting to catch it.
Jackson popped out of his hands. Mathias with the steal.
Nice job by the Buckeyes to thwart the break. It's going to be good old fashioned Big Ten basketball, John.
Big Ten basketball.
Get your elbow pads, your knee pads, a lot of floor burns.
Yeah, Brian Carter on the tip off show. Why not?
There's Haas inside the bucket. Number two on Wesson did
everything right, yep. John, except at the end when he walked up. He walled up at the very end. He stepped in the Haas, and that's why he got the foul.
No, I think where he got the catch in Haas was okay if you're Caleb Wesson. The other key is you can't allow him to turn to the paint. He is so effective with the left shoulder, right hook. It's just too easy when you're 7'3 and 300 pounds.
Well, big problem now for Ohio State. Both Potter and Wesson with a pair of fouls. And Haas with 10 points as we check in with Andy Katz.
Chris Holtman told me that Caleb Wesson had to get to the 10-minute mark with only one foul. Now he's got two past the 10-minute mark. And Isaac Haas told me before the game, he has not had consistent calls on him in the post. He's waiting for officials, essentially, to call consistently. So we have to watch how they will call the physicality with him in this game.
Ball taken away again. Another turnover. Number six for Ohio State.
Tate Harvick way too long down there. Should have pitched it out to Andrew Dockich. Was wide open for three.
Hit by Dockich.
Yeah.
Plucking away.
Dockich, percentage-wise, John, is the best three-point shooter on Ohio State, but he's only made 13 threes out of 26 attempts. He's got to hunt his shot more, especially with Cam Williams out.
Well, I think you always have to be shot ready. He makes a high percentage because he takes good shots. If you're right, he does have to seek out more opportunities, at least be a floor spacer.
Vincent Edwards, 13 to shoot against Andre Wesson. Edwards to work. The spin won't go. Rebound tipped around. It'll go out of bounds, and it'll belong to Ohio State.
How about Jayshon Tate coming down on Isaac Haas? Again, do not tell Jayshon Tate he's 6'4". I don't think he'll believe it.
Haas will leave. So now Harms, the man in the middle for Purdue.
How many fist pumps can we get from Matt Harms today?
At least 10.
He's genuinely annoying to any opponent, but anybody who plays with him loves him.
Slow start for Vincent Edwards tonight. 0 for 5 from the floor for one of the Big Ten's best.
He was puking all last week, missed a couple of games, played great. Now he's feeling well.
Andre Wesson gets all the way to the rim and the easy two once he got there for the sophomore Andre Wesson. 1 point ball game. Living up to the hype so far as we approach the 8-minute mark. And a miscommunication, and that's out of bounds to Ohio State.
Chris Holtman said they wanted to be disruptive. They weren't going to take too many passes away, but they're at least disrupting the action for Purdue. That's going to be what gives themselves a shot in this game. shot even gets up there.
But he talked about doing work early. When Haas has been the most successful, he's done his work early to get position before they get established.
But you got to meet about the foul, and you got to Ole at some point maintain position, force him into a spot that he doesn't want to do work.
Easier said than done.
There's Bates Diop with the turnaround. That dies along the side of the rim. He's just 1 for 5 tonight.
And that's one of the things about Isaac Haas that I think he picked up from Biggie Swanigan. The ability to work, to put the effort into just working harder, not just to get a shot, but to get position.
There's Carson Edwards going to work inside. That's not going to go. Harms battling for the rebound, but a good box out by Potter.
Just keep in mind, Isaac Haas and Matt Painter, they know you don't want them to catch it deep. Everything that they do is designed to allow them to catch it deep, especially with that baseline screening action.
Nice catch and finish by Kata Bates Diop from Andrew Dockett.
They got switched up, and you got Matt Harms away from the basket on Andrew Dockett. And the key with what Dockett did was just step out and get space.
How about that? Villanova upset tonight by St. John's. The number one team in the land goes down, so add some extra stakes to this one.
Can the Red Storm be 1-11 in the Big East and still get a number one seed in the NCAA tournament? I think that's actually possible right now.
Duke and Villanova in back-to-back for the beleaguered St. John's squad. Is Fights with a three.
That's Purdue's first three of the night, only the second made three of this game with 6:44 in the first half.
That was one of the keys. They wanted to take away threes for Purdue. You saw what happened against Iowa. Iowa took Isaac Haas out of the game, but they gave up 20 threes.
Purdue by a pair, 6.5 remaining in this first half. Here's Andrew Dockett. Got an open three, and he airballed it. That is the third Ohio State airball from deep tonight. And the Buckeyes just 1 for 7 from three.
I'm calling for him to hunt his shot, and he shoots an air ball.
Hey, look, I'm glad you brought it back up. I didn't have to throw it back at you.
I mean, Andrew, my man.
No, he's almost too open. Those are some of the toughest shots.
He was open, and getting back to the point that Kevin just made about Haas, which is a good one, you know, when you play Purdue, they're one of the best three-point shooting teams in the entire country, third in the country in three-point shooting. Do you double on the post and try to limit Haas' touches? If he scores down there, it's only 2 points. If you double him, then he's going to find, if not an open shooter, then he's going to get a hockey assist to an open shooter. So that's the poison that Ohio State's been picking.
It's the interesting thing. It doesn't matter who you are. If you're a top five team, pick your poison to stop them always comes into play because they have good balance.
Fifth team foul charged to Ohio State. One so far called against Purdue. That was on Harms. First foul on Dockett.
There's an art to that, too, playing without fouling, and that means get in position defensively. Communicate well so you're not chasing the play.
Haas working against Wesson.
No double.
Haas to work with the hook, and it falls. Haas with 12. Was headed the other way. Terry Weimer said it's a foul. Just the second tonight against Purdue.
It was a foul. I just look at the faces. I mean, there are people in here that I'm afraid what they may do. Terry Weimer, and it was a clear foul. I mean, there's people paying a lot of money for some of these cushion seats, and they're getting up off them quickly.
Bates the off the double team comes. He's in trouble. 10 to shoot. Tate against Haas. Wesson the three. It falls. His second from deep.
That was not in the scouting report. That's what happens in a crazy game like this. You can see Purdue doubling the post, whoever gets it down there, because they're not worried about the three-point shooters.
You saw it from Musa Diallo, and you just saw it from Andre Wesson. You've got to be able to make a shot if it comes your way, which means be shot ready.
That's a foul on Wesson underneath. That's his third.
That's just a great find. I don't know if you really need to commit so much. When Isaac Haas is covering Jayson Tate in the paint, you dig down and you give up an open look. And the last thing you want to do is get guys going. And that's three fouls for Andre Wesson. I don't think that was part of the game plan.
Well, now Kyle Young is going to be forced into action. Excuse me, for the first time tonight. Caleb Wesson sits down with those three fouls. He made it under the 10-minute mark with one, but he's picked up two more in the last 5 minutes. It's Carson Edwards with a three. No, what a foul.
Tay definitely got him. No question about it. Over-aggressive on the closeout.
It's amazing how these three-point shooters have gotten so good at flailing legs, right? And it's not just north and south like it used to be. Now it's east and west. It's brilliant. I mean, you're going to see it. Look, he's going to get him. I don't know if he gets him on. They got a high five and a kick.
Right on the hand.
By the way, Carson Edwards, if you watch him, his balance, of course you look at him, he's built like a pitbull. His balance is terrific. He's able to just rise and fire from any position on the floor.
What a season he's having, huh? Running the team. How about in the Big Ten? 40 assists to 15 turnovers. Last year on the season, he actually had two more turnovers than assists. So he's really matured in his ability to run a team.
10 games, one home. BTN is exclusive coverage of the first 10 games of the 2018 Big Ten Men's Basketball Tournament presented by SoFi Live from Madison Square Garden in New York City beginning February 28th. That's 3 weeks from now.
You know, I got to say, for Carson Edwards, I think the experience in the World University Games is huge. Because remember, he's only a sophomore, but he's having a fantastic year, and he is the leader of this team. If you could pick one, I guess.
Tate down four. Tate on the drive. Goes left hand. Huff changed that shot and got the rebound. Carson Edwards now on the move. The spin to the rim. Won't go. And it'll go the other way. And a foul is going to be called on Isaac Haas. First on Haas. And the third on Purdue as a team.
It's funny with Isaac Haas. He runs so hard, but he just can't stop. It's like a Great Dane. He just gets going. I don't think that was that bad of a foul. It's just that he takes up a lot of room, and he was going hard to the basket.
It's one of the many ways that Purdue can get you. And that's in the fouls department. Ohio State 7, Purdue 3. That is not unusual for the Boilermakers. They are great at defending without fouling.
Here's Kata Bates-Diop with 8 to shoot. Working against Mathias. The turnaround in the paint falls. Bates Diop has yet to heat up. He's got 6, just a 2-point game.
Yeah, they
got
to get him going. I mean, he's the player of the year in the Big Ten. First team All-America, just had 35 points, career high against Rutgers. He's got to take over this game offensively.
Foul on Kyle Young as Isaac Haas again doing work before the entry pass. Young with the foul and a timeout on the floor. Kata Bates Diop trying to heat up. Bring the Buckeyes back down just a pair on the road. We flash back just a couple of weeks, January 25th, the only game that Ohio State has lost in conference play, and it looked like it was going to overtime until Tony Carr, in one of the best finishes in college basketball this year, banked it in to win it for Penn State 82-79. That's the only thing that kept us from having a matchup tonight of two unbeaten Big Ten squads, and Kata Bates-Diop providing the heroics in that one. He was even better against Illinois this past weekend with 35, still trying to find his groove here. 6 points, 4 rebounds on 3-for-7 shooting.
Well, it hasn't exactly been a spectacular offensive night for both of these teams. They're combined 3-for-12 from three-point range. Difference really on the foul line. Purdue 7-for-8. Ohio State 2-for-2. Make that 8-for-9.
Let's check in quickly with Andy Katz.
Well, thank you, Kevin. I talked to Kata Bates-Diop yesterday about that last second in the Penn State game. He says he can't even explain the range of emotions he had because he thought he'd sent it into overtime before Tony Carr shot. By the way, he told me last season when he was hurt, he worked on that mid-range shot we just saw on the other possession down at the end of the court because he worked on his mechanics when he couldn't go up and down the court.
What a bad plan when he was battling the injury from a year ago. They're going to work again against one of the best in the league at trying to stop players like Kata Bates-Diop. Dakota Mathias wins that battle. Vincent Edwards with the rebound.
See, I don't mind that missed shot, John. I think he's got to be firing tonight. It's got to be his night. This is the biggest game of the year.
And defensively, you've got to live with the fact that he may make a bunch of those.
The lob to Haas. Mathias with the vision to find the big man.
Haas is not exactly a high flyer. If he was, goodness gracious, he wouldn't be playing in this league. But he's got great hands. And the fact that you can throw a ball up to Isaac Haas and he can get it, gather, and finish, He's key.
What a night he's had already. 16 points, and Young with the follow on the floater. He'll go to the line after the foul.
Well, Caleb Wesson getting those three fouls, obviously done for the half, and they're going to have to manage him in the second half, John. Now you can't play the type of defense on Haas in the post that you want to play. You could just see that coming a mile away, couldn't you?
And you've got to wonder at some point if you start to change your tack defensively. I know they don't want to overcommit to the post, because we've seen what happens when you let the guards of Purdue get going.
Halftime report coming up. Dual locations, not only in Chicago, but right here at Mackey Arena. Got this thing so well covered tonight. Sean McMahon, Mike Hall, a cast of thousands coming up on the State Farm Halftime Report.
Us three slaps over here.
Yeah, we're not allowed on that show. Young one for two after the second foul called on Dakota Mathias. So Mathias on the bench as P.J. Thompson will walk it up.
I mean, Kyle Young is 6'8", 205-pound freshman. I mean, Haas just dwarfs him down there.
Good play by P.J. Thompson. Edwards finds Carson Edwards for three. Will quiet the crowd again after Purdue establishes its largest lead of the night.
Look, this is not exactly how you draw it up, but this is why Purdue is so tough. You hustle, you scramble, and you end up giving up an open three. It's one of those things where you watch the game back and go, wow, it was a 4 or 5 possession game, yet Purdue won so many of those possessions.
Starts with the seal of Haas sealing Young down low. Edwards drives, Jackson has to help. Basketball is a simple game when you have that kind of spacing for round one.
What do you do if you're Young? Kind of Young down in the post trying to cover Isaac Haas. Pray.
Hope he misses dunks.
Right. He's missed his one tonight.
And hope that your alpha male, Kata Bates Diop, plays like the Big Ten player of the year.
And it's really hard, though, because as a guard, you can kind of dig down, but you can't commit. Because the guards for Purdue just make too many shots. That's going to be too easy.
Haas inside, the foul on Young will at least delay 2 points, although Isaac Haas, one of his most underrated strengths is what he does at the free throw line, John. He's terrific at the stripe and allows him to stay on the floor from the start to the finish.
It is. You got to give him a lot of credit. It's not that easy. I think Shaq showed us that. It's not that easy to make foul shots when you're that big, but Chris Holtman on the sideline was looking for a three-second call. He may have a point, and usually when a coach makes that point, officials will look for it next.
I didn't realize that was still a rule.
I think so, maybe.
Three-second call.
If it's not a point of emphasis, it might as well not be a rule.
And, of course, as we talk up Haas's free
throws. Good. Anything else you want to compliment the one? Well, listen, he shot 55% as a freshman, Isaac Haas, so give him credit on working on that part of his game.
Been two players for the most part for Purdue. Haas with 16, Edwards with 10, and Jayshon Tate unable to come up with that one again as Purdue will bring it up the floor.
I mean, at least Tate is being aggressive.
So it's Carson Edwards. He's got 12. The deep two opens up the 9-point lead.
No one knows how to defend a ball screen at the top of the key in transition. It is one of the most difficult plays to cover, and Purdue does it as well as anybody else.
I think Chris Holtman is actually not happy with Jayshon Tate right now. But at least he's trying to take things over. You know, you want to play some hero ball to see Edwards getting behind that big Haas screen. And when Isaac Haas screens you, you know you've been screened.
And if anything, I think Jayshon Tate's got to force that to the strong side. He cannot allow Carson Edwards to turn over that screen, because if you get hit at all with Isaac Haas, you're in trouble.
Well, Isaac Haas tonight has been tremendous. 16 points, 6 of 7 from the floor.
Well, I call him Isaac House because of the way that he's built, but the key with him is simple positioning. He's been there all night. Caleb Wesson, as a freshman, trying to contain him. Now in three fouls, so he gets you by scoring, he gets you by rebounding, making free throws, and getting your big man into foul trouble. Is that pretty much all there is to it, John?
That's as much as you can say. Now, the interesting thing is we sit here and talk about what you have to do against Isaac Haas. We're all 6 foot and couldn't do any of it, but we have great ideas.
Well, the three posts that have played tonight for Ohio State have a combined 7 fouls called against them. So they've gone smaller now. Bates Diop has to back it out. Musa Jallo in the corner. The three falls. A giant shot for the Buckeyes as Jallo has six, both from three. And it's a six-point game.
I mean, but for some uncharacteristic three-pointers from Jallo and one from Andre Wesson, Buckeyes could be in a lot of trouble right now.
And Klein with the travel. The fifth Purdue turnover gives it back to Ohio State with 1:27 to go. And despite the fact that it's been a ragged first half for the Buckeyes, despite the fact that this crowd has been oppressive, here's Ohio State down six with 90 seconds to go, roughly, and a chance to cut it to four.
But this is the point. This is why you just allow single coverage in the post, because you're not going to get blown out with threes by four perimeter players that could absolutely kill you and put up 50 and a half.
There's Bates Diop. Double team runs at him, chasing into the corner. We got a whistle and a foul away from the ball. That'll go on Jayshon Tate, and for Tate, that's his second personal foul.
The motions are running a little hot right now, Jayshon Tate. I think John makes a great point. It's only a six-point game. You really want to keep your poise.
You got to be patient. I mean, you have to trust that you have the best player on the floor in Kata Bates Diop, and all you want to do is keep it within striking distance to give the best player on the floor, possibly the best player in this conference, a chance to win it.
Klein will jump it down to Haas. P.J. Thompson with an open three from Haas, but Bates Diop the rebound off the miss.
Dodged the bullet there. Can't leave him that open.
Kata Bates Diop from the elbow. Fading away. Gets it to drop. He's got eight, and it's a four-point game.
They need to be running clear outs for Bates Diop the rest of the night. That's going to be their best offense.
I think the confidence is going to come from whatever Kata Bates Diop can get you.
Line into Haas. Backs it out. Working against Andre Wesson underneath. Andre Wesson at 6'6", 220. Vincent Edwards 0 for 5 tonight. Now 0 for 6 and a rebound to Jayshon Tate. And the Buckeyes can hold for the last shot. Tate will put on the brakes. How about this? Ohio State down 4 and a chance to cut it to a pair at halftime.
There's that clear out driving.
Bates the up against Klein. 5 seconds, 4 seconds, finds Tate, got it over the rim. It's a two-point game, and halftime is here at Mackey Arena.
Ohio State found some half-court mojo. Those last couple of possessions, they need to ride that. The rest of the second half, you clear out the space. There's no way Ryan Klein can guard him without enough help. The defense sags in, and he makes the right pass.
Andy Katz standing by with Purdue head coach Matt Painter.
All right, thank you, Kevin. Matt, obviously Ohio State just won a late run to tighten this game up. What's the first thing you're going to tell your team in the locker room?
Well, we just got to slow down offensively. We've had some good drives, some good plays. We haven't been able to knock down some shots. We just got to be able to pass and catch offensively to get a little momentum. Obviously, we have an advantage with Haas, and we got to take advantage of that, but we also got to take some shots in rhythm on the perimeter. But they're a good team. They've knocked down some shots by some non-three-point shooters and really kept us in this game. So we just got to do a little bit better job of knowing where they're at.
Thanks, Matt.
Thanks.
Back to you guys.
A 7-0 run to close the half for me.
And I like what Andy Katz got from both coaches. Matt Painter headed into the locker room. Chris Holtmann coming out. They both said we got to settle down offensively. And I think that's true because neither team got into a rhythm. I say the first team that gets into a rhythm offensively wins this game.
And I have to say, even though Isaac Haas is sitting here with 16 points, so he's on pace to be over 30, I do think the strategy of letting him get his twos and clamping down on Purdue's threes is helping Ohio State stay in this game. Purdue makes 10 threes a game. That's most in the Big Ten. They only have two in that first half.
On Vincent Edwards, no points in the first half. 0 for 6 from the floor as Wesson working against Haas. Can't get that to go. And the rebound by Carson Edwards on the weak side for Purdue.
It's another strength of Purdue that you can't say enough about. You have active guards, not just what they do in terms of moving their bodies and switching on defense, but they're active on the glass.
Yeah, third rebound already tonight for Carson Edwards. Not afraid to go inside as Bates Diop swipes it away from Vincent Edwards. 10 to shoot, and it'll stay with Purdue. They'll inbound.
Yeah, there's not enough talk both tonight and on the season about how good Ohio State has been defensively this season, and I would start with Bates Diop. He's the leading scorer in the Big Ten. I think he's actually more valuable to this club on the defensive end. And their defense is what's keeping them in this game when they really don't have much of a right to be, given how they've shot.
And they're different from, like, an Illinois who's going to be disruptive and make you uncomfortable. They just play safe defense. They force you to take a tough shot like this in a late shot clock situation.
And the rebound to Tate. One to shoot when Mathias launched that deep three.
I think Wisconsin has shown us that you can play safe basketball. And I'll put that in quotes. Good shot. Tate lines one up. That was way off. They can play safe basketball. Don't beat yourself. Don't foul. And you're going to give yourselves a chance to win 20 straight NCAA tournaments and 16 years in a row where you're top four finishing conference.
Mathias in trouble and a turnover. Coughed it up for the sixth time as Purdue gives it back. We had a ragged start to this game. A little bit ragged to start in the first minute and change here in the second half. Andre Wesson. Now back over to Jayshon Tate. Tate trying to get it going. Just 5 points tonight on 2-for-5 shooting. Deep two for Caleb Wesson. And Carson Edwards, his fourth rebound. Looking to push. P.J. Thompson back to Carson Edwards.
All those red shirts back. Great transition defense.
Haas to the rim. An easy two for the big man.
On the move, big fella. Screen and slip to the glass. Finish with the left. That's a big-time move.
It looked kind of awkward, man. He was extended out. Great balance. Good finish. Good setup by Carson Edwards.
18 for Haas. Four-point lead for the Boilermakers. Jackson off the screen for three. Won't go. Rebound tipped around into the hands of Jayshon Tate, who puts it in.
Talk about Purdue's vulnerability on the backboard. It's been a problem all year. They've been out-rebounded their last six games. Those guys can get them there.
Just the second offensive rebound of the night combined. Purdue has zero offensive boards.
Wesson's just got to sit and wall them up.
Haas inside, could get it to go. Wesson trying to coax a call, couldn't get that one either.
It wasn't a foul on Wesson, it's a win right now for Iowa State. That's all they're worried about.
HD off the handoff to Jackson, shovels it underneath, and there is going to be a travel before any contact. Caleb Wesson with the turnover.
And Caleb Wesson just seems to be second-guessing everything, and that's what happens when you get into early foul trouble. There's no rhythm to the game for a young guy who needs to just get some catches, kind of feel like he's a part of the process. If anything, I thought he might have gotten pushed a little.
And it's gone in the second half. Vincent Edwards looking inside to Haas, battling with Wesson. Haas demanding it, and there's the foul, number four.
See, that should be a foul on Haas. And there was a moment even before that that they could have called a foul on Haas. You can run that replay. Literally has his elbow in Wesson's neck. I mean, look, Haas is clearing space with his elbow here. That's an offensive foul. You can't do that.
I think that's what Caleb Wesson's trying to say.
I mean, I understand he's big, and that's where his elbow tends to be, but he's got it planted in Wesson's neck.
Look, I couldn't officiate a six-footer, but I certainly couldn't officiate Isaac Haas. I mean, that is a whole other beast. We saw it with Shaq in the NBA. It's this Shaq rule, you know? Well, you can't call the foul. You're going to foul him every single time.
It's a game changer. That's, you know, four on Wesson. We got a long way to go here.
And I think you go right back inside at this point if you're Purdue. But you don't want to just take it out of the guards' hands. You're going to need guards to make shots down the stretch.
Potter on the floor now for Ohio State. Sets the screen for Jackson. Has to get rid of it to Potter. Now 10 to shoot. Tate going to work against Edwards. The dump down to Potter for the flush. We're tied at 33.
In the first half, Tate was forcing that shot. Much better decision.
If Jayshon Tate's going to the right, Isaac Haas doesn't help. But to the left, Jayshon Tate can make that shot, so you got to commit.
Purdue really needs to get Vincent Edwards going here. Still scoreless. Then their leading scorer in Big Ten.
Mathias the three.
Can't lose him.
If Isaac Haas is going to set screens, you're going to have success with whoever comes off. Because Isaac Haas has also done a good job of rolling. And that's been the criticism, that he doesn't do that well enough.
Potter inside. Haas is there. And there's the second foul on Isaac Haas.
Jayshon Tate, if he's going to his left, you've got to help out. But if Isaac Haas is going to be a screener, all you got to do is stand there, Isaac Haas, and you're going to get guys open.
They are Austin 18, Carson Edwards with 12, and Matthias has 6. Those are the only 3 Boilermakers who have scored. That's unusual for what's been a very well-balanced team.
Our auto owners insurance game leaders, Austin Edwards, the only 2 in double figures in the game tonight. 2 of the 3 Purdue players to score as Micah Potter goes to the line. For 7, Ohio State as a team at the line tonight.
I think balance is great, and that's what's made this Purdue team a top 5 team. Probably to win this game, they're going to slide on up. But I also understand playmakers are going to make plays, and that's what happens when you play in a good defensive team, a disciplined defensive team like Ohio State.
Well, they gave him an extra one here.
Was that because of Matt Harms stepping out early?
I believe it was, yes.
Ah, that's weak. Come on.
You don't like lane violations? Are you scrapping
that? He was going to talk. He didn't step in. Kind of step behind Kata Bates-Diop.
So Potter got 3 attempts.
They don't have 2 count lane violations in the Netherlands, apparently?
Yeah, I guess so. Well, yeah, over there you just walk all over the place. 2 shots.
Still not a point from Vincent Edwards.
Good try here, perhaps. Bates-Diop got a hand on it. Lost it. Carson Edwards. Tipped by Jayshon Tate and out of bounds. It'll stay with Purdue, 7 to shoot.
Is this Buckeyes defense any good?
Look, the length of Kata Bates-Diop is really frustrating Vincent Edwards, because the second Vincent Edwards goes to put it down, Kata Bates-Diop jumps back and uses his length to negate the shot.
Edwards with 5 to shoot. Got the screen from Harms. The 3 goes down.
Everything right. Edwards just a little bit better. Biggest shot of the game so far.
15 for Edwards. Here's Bates-Diop trying to get it going, and he hits the deep fadeaway in the corner.
You got to do it. You've got to trust the best player in the conference to keep this game close when you need a bucket, especially when you've got Caleb Weston on the bench for 4 fouls. It hasn't really gotten going in this game.
I sat in on the Purdue pregame film session. One thing Matt Painter said to those guys is don't get discouraged if Bates-Diop makes tough shots. That's what he does. I think he needs to hunt it more.
Vincent Edwards, first bucket of the night.
He hit those 3s and the stars flashing. That could be trouble for Ohio State.
With a rejection. He's fired up. So is this crowd. PJ Thompson almost lit the fuse again, but Harms called for the foul. Trying to get the rebound against Potter.
I'm disappointed. I thought I was going to get a fist bump out of Matt Harms. We got nothing out of that. But Vincent Edwards, we said he couldn't get anything going. He lined that one up. He caught that in rhythm. He knew he was going up to shoot that shot. Because I think Kata Bates-Diop has been playing the drive first. I like that aggressiveness from Vincent Edwards to get something going on the offensive end.
Feels like a real pivotal moment in this game. Purdue by 6. Crowd back into it. Ohio State's got to get it in this guy's hands. Kata Bates-Diop going to work. The fadeaway against Matthias won't go. The rebound to Matthias.
I'd be going to that well all night long. I don't care if it goes in. Hose him down. You better hose him down.
Edwards nearly with the steal.
Carson Edwards has completely taken over this game.
Carson Edwards is the kind of guy, if you let him get going, he's going to be able to create enough space to get
shots off, and the three-point shot was what Ohio State was able to contain in the first half. So far, not able to do it in the second. Wow, this place just got rocking. Mackey, do your thing.
Fiat is Purdue's taking the 9-point lead, and what a benefit it is for Matt Painter to have the senior stability that he has with this team. Vincent Edwards, P.J. Thompson, Dakota Mathias, Isaac Haas, 67 or more career starts, and almost 12,000 combined career minutes. Andy, this Purdue squad, very stable in big moments.
Yeah, they are, Kevin, and you've called a number of different names in this second half, making big shots, and that's exactly what Dakota Mathias, Isaac Haas, Vincent Edwards have all told me. That's why this is a better basketball team without Caleb Swanigan. Obviously, you could use them, but they're more balanced. Each player respects each other. They trust each other. They built that trust last summer in Taiwan when they got that silver medal in the World University Games. They don't care who makes the big shot. We're seeing it here in the second half.
I love the caveat. Like, you have to say, hey, look, look, we'll take him. We'll take Caleb Swanigan to find a spot for him. I think you have to show respect. That goes. Oh, no. I think you got to show respect to Caleb Swanigan for what he did for this program. And it wasn't just what you saw on the floor. It was all the intangibles and the hard work that went into making him who he was.
Bates Diop barely draws iron. Ohio State out of sorts right now. Purdue up 9 with a ball.
And let's not discount the fortune. And I almost don't want to say this out loud, but they've been healthy. I mean, they've had the same starting lineup for all 25 games. Not a lot of basketball teams can say that for a variety of reasons. Most of all, injuries.
Carson Edwards has had the hot hand. Here's Mathias with 9 to shoot.
Excellent closeout by Andrew Dockett.
Arms and a foul called on Jayshon Tate. With the shot clock winding down, he gets his third.
That was a really bad foul because you've got him playing with his back to the basket 15 feet away from the hoop. There's no reason to reach in there.
You got to make him put the ball on the floor first before you try to get a steal. There's no reason because it's so easy on a rip through to pick up that foul. Let him put the ball down on the deck first.
Each team's been whistled for a pair of fouls in this second half.
That being said, I like the fact that Jayshon Tate wants to bring this thing back.
Vincent Edwards with the 2. Haas back on the floor, tips the rebound, but into the arms of Andre Wessel.
This Ohio State lineup's got to fly around. This is a small lineup. They got to make Isaac Haas work, and that shot's got to go.
Too strong. C.J. Jackson, though, with the offensive rebound.
With a small lineup right now with Bates Diop at the 5 and Jayshon Tate at the 4. And Jayshon Tate at the college 4 is a very difficult matchup.
He got matched up against P.J. Thompson. Pretty easy pickings for Tate. 7-point lead for Purdue.
You're going super small against a big physical team.
Edwards around the screen. And Carson Edwards.
He's just feeling it. You cannot let Carson Edwards get into this kind of a rhythm and this type of confidence.
It's the balance. He's able to turn the corner, put it on the floor once, go straight up. While the defense is half sideways trying to catch up.
Look at how he hawks the ball, too.
Low pass to Wesson. Wesson to kick into the corner. 10 to shoot. Jackson down the baseline with Thompson on him. Jackson fighting his way to the rim, and a foul is going to be called. 47-38 and a timeout at Mackey Arena. Chris Holtman trying to find a way to get his team to rally in this one. Matt Painter likes what he sees from the third-ranked Boilermakers.
When he talks about being strong with the basketball, it means not getting stripped and not throwing lazy passes for turnovers. They have 8 on the game, but really, the difference here in the second half, John, clearly the three-point shot, Purdue 4-for-6, Ohio State 0-for-5. I think that first half maybe was a little bit of an illusion because of the threes from Jallo and Andre Weston. They really miss Cam Williams, who is their best three-point shooter, who's suspended for violating team rules. He's going to be back probably next week or certainly by the week after, but not only missing his three-point shooting, but the fact that the defense has to honor his three-point shooting, which creates space.
And Carson Edwards with a 3 and a foul.
It's getting from bad to worse real quick here for the Buckeyes.
I think what Matt Painter said in that huddle, as simple as it was, it just exuded confidence. So if I'm a player in the huddle saying, wait, all we got to do is execute, basically what Matt Painter's saying is, I take us over them. Just do the simple things right, and I take us over them. That'll help, too.
And I was also in the Ohio State film session this morning, and that was something that Gary Johnson, the assistant, and Chris Holtman emphasizes, not losing those baseline cutters. You got to really stay attached to that hip. These produced outside shooters don't need a whole lot of space, especially number three.
Carson Edwards, what a night. 24 points for the seventh leading scorer in the conference.
He's trying to guard Bates Diop.
And a foul is going to be called. Tough pass for Kata Bates Diop. And the foul the first on Carson Edwards.
I'm not sure Bates Diop has scored here in the second half.
Purdue's done a good job of just being aware of where he's at all times. He's forced him to catch in a bad spot and then contested a tough shot.
Just 2 second-half points for Kata Bates Diop. Jackson, the deep three. Off the heel. Jallo had the rebound. Taken away by Klein. Klein up the floor. The bounce to Edwards. And he's got 26. Dockett short. Bates Diop with the follow.
Times a bad miss is the easiest one to get an offensive rebound. But for Purdue, they are starting to feel it. You can just sense that they have confidence in what they're doing on the offensive end. They feel good about where they're at defensively. And they also think they have the guys on the floor that you want to be on the floor because there's no foul trouble.
Edwards again. And that one, a little too off for Edwards. Dockett. The push, Jallo wide open. And Musa Jallo with his third three of the night.
That's just a great find. Andrew Dockett's keeping his head up. And Musa Jallo, because of the confidence after making two in the first half, he actually runs to the three-point line.
He made it eight all year coming in.
First three of the second half made for Ohio State. And Haas fouled on the catch by Wesson.
Just look at the vision from Andrew Dockett. He's looking up. Look, he's not going to look to go to the basket, so that's a pretty cool. He sees it. He just looks off Musa Jallo, finds him in the corner, and again, confidence. Shoot the ball, get him into it first hand.
Let's check in quickly with Andy Katz.
All right, thank you, Kevin. We talked to Scooney Penn before the game, who's on the Ohio State bench, and he said words cannot express what Andrew Dockett has meant to this team. He stays in his lane. He doesn't overextend. He makes the right plays. He does exactly what he is told. He's been the perfect add for this team.
Ayshon Tate with a good play inside, the battle for it on the ground, and a whistle. And that's going to be a foul against Purdue. It'll be on Haas.
How do you give a foul on Haas? I'm sure he fouled somebody. Just every time he moves, he bumps into somebody. But this is an absolute rugby scrum. It's just bodies rolling all over the place. I guess he did.
There's the foul.
Tossed Andrew Dockett like a rag ball.
Oh, my gosh. Raggedy Ann just got thrown to the Purdue bench. Wow.
I think the refs really wanted to let that scrum go.
They let it go for a while. But then you have to just call it on. Now look, everybody's booing. I didn't think it was a foul first till I saw it.
I'm not sure they've shown that part of the replay here at Mackey.
They're selective with the replays.
13 to shoot. Ayshon Tate.
How about the job Dakota Mathias has done on Bates Diop? Now he switched on Tate.
Harms got in there to disrupt that. No, Joe Easter will start it the other way.
The guy who's only scored 6 points tonight, Dakota Mathias, as usual, having a huge impact on Purdue winning.
Klein tipped and taken away. Jallo to the other end. Klein coming in. They would have counted that had it gone. Dockett asking, would it have been an intentional?
It was actually quite close because he just pushed him in the back. He wasn't making an obvious play for the ball. But I don't think he necessarily pushed him hard enough. Let's see here, John. You've got to make a play on the ball.
I think he made a play on the ball with the left hand. I just don't think Ryan Clyde could have caught up with him. I think that was the problem. Look. It's not much.
I don't think you call that intentional.
Don't call that a flagrant one.
I think Chris Holtman's arguing opposite of your argument. Free throw good for Jallo. Sunday night, BTN's original series, The Journey's all new with stories on Dakota Mathias and Andrew Dockage, plus can't miss behind-the-scenes footage of this game between the Buckeyes and Boilermakers. Don't miss an all-new episode of The Journey, fueled by Gatorade, Sunday, 9:30 Eastern, right here on BTN.
When you heard Matt Painter telling his guys about executing and being strong with the ball, those last two possessions were the opposite of what he was talking about. That's exactly his concern. They've allowed Ohio State to staunch the bleeding. That's a charge.
And there's the call.
Part of the issue is the lineup they've got on the floor. You got no Jeff Easter, you got Matt Harms, you got Ryan Klein, guys that haven't played significant minutes. And Vincent Edwards feels as if he's got to take over. You got to get back to get the guys that you need on the floor and get that balance back.
For Ohio State, but the Buckeyes on a mini 6-0 run, and the lineup has changed again for Purdue. And the starters, all five, back out on the floor for the Boilermakers.
I mean, it might sound odd to extol Ohio State's defense, given that Purdue's shooting 49%, 57% in the second half. But, you know, Purdue only averages 11 turnovers a game. They're second in the league, and they've got 11 turnovers to this point.
Deshaun Tate, and that's going to be a foul on Vincent Edwards. Number two on Edwards. And the eighth whistled against Purdue in the second half, so a one-on-one opportunity for the Buckeyes, which has not been necessarily great news for Ohio State. They're just 7 of 12 at the line tonight.
Well, the foul story has now flipped, so Purdue's got 8 to Ohio State's 4. Maybe they can make up some ground on the foul line. John, it just feels like Ohio State's offense is putting so much pressure on their defense that as soon as Purdue's able to string together a couple of shots, yep, the game breathes, and it's just a very high mountain to climb.
Now, the ball hasn't moved, and it really hasn't moved since Caleb Weston went out of the game. They're used to playing more traditional basketball where you can play four out, one in, but Caleb Weston is that guy you can throw the ball in the post to and then move around. So it's gotten stagnant in the second half with Weston with his four fouls.
Haas, by the way, had 16 at halftime. So far, only two in the second half with this small lineup.
Small lineup, I'll tell you.
Which is often how it works.
Vincent Edwards, that's a foul on Bates Diop at the top of the key. That'll be number one on Bates Diop. This has been a very slow 7-0 Ohio State run.
Quiet run, so to speak, all right? You barely know what's happening. I think if you're Matt Painter and crew, you got to go back to what got Carson Edwards shots, what got Dakota Mathias shots. You got to use Isaac Haas as a screener as much as possible, even though he's probably going to get fouled every single time.
But also, you got to make them pay for going small.
I mean, yeah.
If they're going to make it hard for you on one end, you got to let the big dog eat on this end. And again, he's setting screens for the purpose. I mean, Andre Wesson, what do you want him to do?
Well, that's the wrong Wesson.
You know what they ought to do? You know, remember back in like junior high school where one guy gets on all fours behind him and you shove him behind him?
That's what you got to do. I don't know what you're talking about. I don't know where you went.
Thompson off the heel. Dockage the rebound. 7-point lead for Purdue. Can Ohio State continue to chip away? Tate looking for Bates Diop. Mathias cloaking him, but what a finish by Kata Bates Diop. Mathias closed him out from the front, so he put his back to the basket and flipped it in.
How about this response from Ohio State? How about this response?
Carson Edwards fouled by Dockage. Let's go back to that Kata Bates Diop play. It's our BTN standout presented by Discover.
Look, presence of mind, understanding where you're at, good body control, knowing that if you bring it down, you're going to have to deal with Isaac Haas. You just can't say enough about the poise and control of the game. Kata Bates Diop, he's an absolute pro.
I mean, with this lineup, Isaac Haas, like he's in no man's land looking for someone to guard. He's like, he's lonely, but he was in no man's land. He wasn't going to go out. You know, he's matched up against Andrew Dockage. Let's see who Isaac Haas is assigned to right now. He's got Weston. Well, he could get switched off to an even smaller player, make him defend in space.
5-point ball game, 6:22 to go. Kata Bates Diop on the drive, trying to take over. He can't, and a foul is going to be called. It'll be a foul going against the Buckeyes, and Jayshon Tate can't believe he just got called for his fourth.
He also got a little tangled up with the official there, too. He's got to tamp down his emotions there, young fella.
Look, He's just driving. I mean, look, that's an obvious foul. He's just leaning into Vincent Edwards. And look, I get it. I love Jayshon Tate as a player. But the key for him is staying on the floor. I know you're going to give me everything, but I need you to be able to stay on the floor.
Now Chris Holtman's going to leave him on the floor.
You're going to have to.
With those four fouls, really not much of a choice. Got to roll the dice. Because I do think that this...
They got it right, by the way.
Smaller lineup's been working for him, and they look to see who's supposed to get fouled.
I think it was Vincent Edwards.
They're checking to see, was it Edwards or was it Thompson? That was the question being asked.
Yeah, and good quick check. That's great. No free timeouts.
Yeah, and by the way, even if it wasn't quick, the players should not be allowed to be huddling with the coach.
I agree with that. 100%.
Don't get me going on replays, John Crispin.
Well, I've got about 7 rule changes this year. I got goaltending should be allowed. Take out the block charge. I already forget the other ones. That happens. They're good ones, though. They were really good.
I love them all. That snaps the 9-0 run. And, of course, the stakes tonight, which is 3 weeks to go until the tournament. The winner of this game is atop the Big Ten standings.
And don't forget, Purdue's got Michigan State next.
I know Purdue hasn't forgotten that.
Well, they better not be thinking about that now. They got some work to do.
7-point game as Ohio State tries to find some offense. Jayshon Tate with 4 fouls. The kick to Andre Wesson. His 3 falls. Andre Wesson has been a revelation. He's got 8 points tonight, and he's hit from behind the arc, as has Musa Diallo. Big threes.
And that's the guy Isaac Haas is guarding. And now he's got to guard Haas on the other end. You got to make him pay.
And a steal trying to get it to Haas. Dokic intercepts the pass. Here's Diallo. His 3 in transition won't go, and there's an injured Buckeye. Jayshon Tate is still down on the other end. It's 5-on-4. Here's Vincent Edwards. The 3!
That's a tough break for Ohio State.
Jayshon Tate, what a nothing from Isaac Haas, who just tried to say, hey, I'm sorry. I don't know what I did, but I'm sorry.
Well, you know, the officials have to let the transition play out. Let's see what happened to Tate. You see number 1 there. Oh, my goodness. Oof.
Yeah, don't stand on the tracks when the train's coming through. My goodness.
I mean, that's it. You're going to wake up tomorrow feeling like you got into a car accident. You basically did.
I think that clip's going to be sent to somebody in some office somewhere to look at why that wasn't a foul. They just missed that one.
Wesson trying to work against Harms, and there's a foul.
And Jayshon Tate standing in the lane and gets 7'10", 290, squaring his back.
I got to give Jayshon Tate credit. He actually stepped in front of Isaac Haas. Look at this. He steps in front. Look, he lined it up.
He was looking for it.
Yeah, he was. He was looking for it. I give Jayshon Tate all the credit in the world.
He's entitled to that space. Maybe I don't know if he's intentionally drawing the foul, but
it's hard, though, because he's sliding over to block out, yet Isaac Haas ran him over. Oh, man.
Isaac Haas was definitely not attempting to change any direction. And now they're playing 5-on-4 defense at the other end, and you give up an open 3-pointer.
Yeah, there was no downshift from the 18-wheeler. I think they call that gear braking or something. Some trucker right now is going to meme tweet me.
Andre Wesson with 10 points. Foul trouble for Ohio State, significant. Caleb Wesson and Jayshon Tate each with 4.
And it's interesting that Caleb Wesson hasn't come back in with those 4 fouls.
Vincent Edwards against Kata Bates. Diop couldn't get the roll, and it's out of bounds off the hand of Isaac Haas. And in a 5-point game, the Buckeyes get it back.
How about Andre Wesson? He is just working down there. You got to give those guys credit. I don't think I need to say it ain't easy. And he is just getting a body, and it's not about him getting the rebound. It's about allowing a teammate to get it.
Just his 2nd career start tonight. He's been huge.
Diallo looking for Bates. Diop, good catch. Got the finish. 3-point game. Mackey Arena, number 3, Purdue. Number 14, Ohio State.
Tell you what, the Boilermakers were this close to blowing the doors off this place. And Ohio State has clawed back behind a small lineup and intense defense.
Double comes now on Haas. He'll fight through it. Won't get the roll. Bates D off the rebound. And the Buckeyes nearly cough it up. Jackson will reset. 4 minutes to play. C.J. Jackson around the Wesson screen. Back it goes to Wesson. Rotation around to Dockage. One-point game.
That's what happens when the ball moves. It changes sides of the floor, and you lost Dockage in the corner. Thought you were going to get a closeout. No one came down. No backside help, and Dakota Mathias just a couple steps late.
It sounds counterintuitive. When you go smaller, you become more difficult to defend.
Offensive rebound for Carson Edwards. The first offensive rebound of the night for Purdue, and Edwards is going to the line.
Good ball movement on the offensive side for Ohio State. You've got to find a way to force bounce. You know Kade Bates-Diop's going to be your guy, but ball changes sides of the floor. And lo and behold, Andrew Dockage.
Back to West Lafayette and Ken Goodwin.
Thank you, Michelle. We are excited to be here with several thousand of our closest friends at Mackey Arena. 58-57, Purdue by one. Kade Bates-Diop trying to get it going late.
You do not want this game to be close if you're Purdue or a Boilermaker fan, because this man has the opportunity at any given point to just take over the basketball game. If it's close, you know they're going to be going into Kade Bates-Diop. And I learned over the break one important thing. It's called Jake Break. There are trucker friends I have out there. It's called Jake Breaking.
I don't know.
18-5 run for Ohio State. No Jake Breaking for Ohio State.
Stuff. It's the important things.
That's all that matters.
Got to get it all in.
Well, it's interesting that, you know, the one scenario that Chris Holtmann feared the most was Caleb Wesson getting into foul trouble. He got into that foul trouble, forcing Holtmann to go small, bringing Andrew Dockage off the bench, moving Bates Diop to the five. Haas isn't going to guard Bates Diop. There's no way he can chase him around. And it's the small lineup, which was created by the thing that Chris Holtmann didn't want to have happen, which is why we got a close game here.
And Carson Edwards, a career-high 28 points, pacing Purdue tonight. And Bates Diop against Mathias. He'll fire over Mathias, left it short with Edwards grabbing the board, and Vincent Edwards has not had a big scoring night, but that's his ninth rebound. Minutes to play. Three-point game.
Isaac Haas not in the game.
Carson Edwards is, though, driving in. The off-balance floater not going to go. Rebound tipped out Holmes, but it was Edwards who kept it alive.
Carson Edwards just has fight. He just gets after it. And as great as he is as a player, he's even a better competitor. I think that's what's inspiring to teammates.
It's an interesting concession that Painter puts Haas on the bench.
Good rebound by Wesson inside against Holmes. Jackson on the push, end to end. Holmes recovers for the rejection.
I've been waiting for my fist bump all game. And I don't want to say I'm rooting for anybody, but here it comes. Fist pump, hair flowing. Harms Bakery.
.213 to go. Jackson with 12 to shoot. And a timeout.
Good timeout. Good timeout. You had nothing going in that possession. It's a three-point basketball game, and you've got to be able to get a good look. We cannot allow Purdue to just completely take over this game with 2 minutes and 6 seconds left.
That is one thing that Matt Harms can do better than Isaac Haas. Yes. You saw his defense extending out to the three-point line. And that huge wingspan, there's really nowhere else to throw it.
Well, after the game, the Big Show's going to deliver highlights from around the conference, post-game reaction, in-depth expert analysis, a lot of talk, I'm sure, about this one. Don't miss the Big Show coming up after the game right here on BTN.
I just feel like
This is the perfect opportunity for Chris Holtmann and his staff to draw up something to get Kata Bates-Diop somewhere around the basket. Because when he's somewhere around the basket, good things happen. I also trust Kata Bates-Diop to make a pass if it means making the right pass. He always makes the right play.
Our Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance game reset. Three timeouts left for Purdue. Only one remaining for Ohio State. Each team with nine fouls, which means the double bonus for the rest of the way after another foul and possession arrow pointing towards the Boilermakers.
Well, I'm going to guess they're going to let Tayshaun Tate initiate this sequence. Do what they can to get Mathias off of Bates-Diop.
Nine on the shot clock. Into Jackson. Gotta go to work. Five to shoot. Jackson. The fake. The floater rolls all the way around at home.
That was a YMCA ball fake.
You look over, show the ball, and it's going to be a timeout for Matt Painter.
Chris Holtmann showing a lot of confidence in C.J. Jackson. Put the ball in his hands.
But that shot. I mean, look, they wanted to get the ball into Kata Bates-Diop, but obviously good ball pressure took that away. And I think this is a great timeout again for Matt Painter. You want to make sure you get ball movement. That's the thing. That's what helps. You call timeout, you get ball movement.
Now watch right after the shot. C.J. Jackson, after the fake, the floater, as he backed up, kind of limping a little bit as he makes his way up the floor and grimacing ever so slightly as well. 1 point game, 150 remaining in this one. It's everything you would want, guys, in a battle for the top spot in the Big Ten. We've got 3 weeks to go before the conference tournament, and we're getting a nice little preview of what we might see in Madison Square Garden.
Oh, we sure are. I mean, look, you're going to see high-level basketball. What people don't realize, this is the top of the conference, but from top to bottom, it's been incredibly competitive all year. And I've said it about Illinois. It's been Rutgers at times. He's taken Purdue to the wire. But these are two of the best.
Entry to Haas. Double team comes. Back out Vincent Edwards for three. And the rebound to Tate. Buckeyes can grab the lead with a bucket here. Purdue's missed six straight. Wesson, he'll fire. Banks it home. Andre Wesson using the window to give the Buckeyes the two-point lead. To play.
This is where I think trying to feed it inside the paint too much is actually getting Purdue stagnant.
Vincent,
that's
Edwards
a tough one.
They've been waiting on Vincent Edwards all night. He's been their best overall player in the Big Ten season.
The offense has gotten stagnant to the point where you're just trying to feed Isaac Haas. The ball movement hasn't been there. A lot of standing. And Vincent Edwards is just able to make a play.
Two for two tonight. 10 points, nine rebounds for Edwards.
Well, you set it up. One timeout left for Ohio State. Purdue with a one-point lead. Two timeouts for them. Both are in the double bonus.
Matt Painter calling timeout. I wonder if he's going to go back to Matt Harms for the defensive substitution. He brought in Isaac Haas back for the offense.
And there's only so much you can do if Andre Weston's going back in the three. I thought he should have shot it right away. If Andre Weston just caught it and shot it right here, it would have been a good shot. I don't know how that happened. It was high off the square.
It's been a three-man game so far for the most part for Purdue, but it's been balanced for the Buckeyes. Kata Bates-Diop, Andre Wesson, Tayshaun Tate, Musa Diallo. A couple of those names on that list are not names you would have expected to be in double figures in a game of this magnitude, Diallo and Wesson.
Ohio State outscoring them 18-0 off the bench. And Harms is back in the game because of his mobility and his ability to recover and hit the defensive glass.
For Purdue, you got to play straight up. Don't gamble. Make them make a tough shot. For Ohio State, you obviously want the ball to touch Kata Bates-Diop at some point.
There's Jackson. Tayshaun Tate looking for Bates-Diop. Mathias all over him.
Looking Harms on that switch.
Here's Dockett trying to get it to Bates. Diop can't get it there. Six to shoot. Gotta hurry. Tate with three on the shot clock. Tate driving. Tate's floater. No! Rebound tipped out. Dockett takes it away. And the Buckeyes now can hold for the final shot. They'll use their final timeout.
Wow.
We talked early on about, for all of Purdue's size, they are not a good rebounding team. And it really cost them there. It could cost them this game, John.
And part of the problem is Matt Harms likes to go for the block. And when Matt Harms goes for a block and commits to the basketball, you've got to have guards getting back into the play and securing it. That time, everybody just runs to the ball. And it's going to be interesting right now. Again, you got to think Kade Bates, Diop touches the ball. You're not going to get it to him that easily in the post. And I think it'd be fine to get him a catch on the wing, send him through to the block, and then try to get him involved, because just sticking him on the block is not going to be too hard for Purdue to take away.
Big show coming up next. Plenty to talk about after this one.
Wow, man.
Plenty to see here in the final 16.2 seconds. Mentioned the final timeout utilized by Ohio State in our Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance game reset. One timeout left for Purdue. Free throws aplenty on any foul. Possession arrow still favoring the Boilermakers with 16 seconds to go.
Now, the last time they came out of a huddle, they let C.J. Jackson initiate the offense so he could not only be a scorer but also a decision maker. If you go back to him, if you go back to Jayshon Tate or Andrew Dockett, you've got a lot of good options. But I agree with John. At the end of the day, it's got to go to Bates Diop.
Andy Katz, what'd you hear in the Purdue huddle?
Well, Matt Painter stressed, make sure you watch the weak side. As you guys know, a lot of times it's not the first shot, it's the second shot. They got to watch the weak side here in the final 16 seconds.
I think you go to Bates Diop in the post.
Here's Tate, 13 seconds amidst the din in Mackey, trying to win it for the Buckeyes. Tate to work, Jayshon Tate on the drive. No, the tip won't go. Bates Diop is there, tips it in with 2.8 seconds to go. Buckeyes by one and a timeout by Purdue.
Did Andy Katz not just say it? A lot of times it's not the first one, it's the second shot. And not corralling the rebound may lose them this game. 3 seconds, still a lot of time. And for Purdue, you've got to advance the ball up the court quickly. Got to catch the ball on the fly, but this is tremendous. Great contest. But again, everybody just runs to the basketball and Kade Bates Diop. I'm not sure what they're looking at. Probably just a clock issue at the moment.
It starts with Jayshon Tate forcing the rotation.
Wow.
Vincent Edwards was able to get a one hand on it, but didn't ask it. So you got to watch for somebody setting a screen and trying to get a player foul on the screener. But mostly you want to keep it out of Carson Edwards' hand if you can.
With 10 minutes to go, Purdue led by 14.
Goss is an outlet at this point.
They need a bucket here with 2.8 seconds or their streak is over. Mathias has got to get it in. The long pass inbounds. Haas with the catch. Haas the fadeaway. No! And Ohio State is the leader in the Big Ten Conference with 3 weeks to play. They knock off Purdue 64-63, ending the Boilermakers' 19-game winning streak.
We said it. If you're able to keep this game close, you give Kade Bates Diop, one of the best players in the country, the best player in this conference, a chance to win the game, and that's exactly what happened.
This was a first-grade theft. Ohio State was on the ropes all night. Purdue pushed out to a double-digit lead with those made threes. They went small. And look at Caleb Wesson, who basically didn't play the entire second half because of foul trouble.
Wow, look, they got a shot. That's the thing. I mean, I don't know if you really expect a foul called in that point.
I don't think there was any foul.
Spot. There's no